Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
Country, if you will, bow your heads with me. Almighty God, we come today to honor you. We come to acknowledge that you are the only one who can rightly lead and guide our country. You are mighty and you are merciful. We need your might and we need your mercy. It is 2015. Lord, let it be time. Let it be time for our country to come back to you. Let it be time for each of us in this nation to personally approach you in humbleness, ready to listen to your wisdom, and ready to walk in integrity and love toward you and each other. Lord, we pray that all the hatred and violence in our country would give way to a new season of godliness, overflowing with an abundance of your love and peace. Help us all to deeply yearn for a new era of kindness and respect. We pray for our leaders, touch them, stir them, and draw them toward selflessness and wisdom. Change their focus and their goals so that their actions match up with your will for our country. We pray for all our military men and women. We ask that you would abundantly bless in every way each serviceman and woman, each veteran, and each military family, past and present. Today we pause to honor them and remember that our country owes them a huge debt of gratitude. We pray that our country will enter a new season of respect and gratitude for those who have sacrifice so much in order to serve our country. We specifically pray for divine protection for all our military personnel, both here and around the world. Surround them and deflect harm from them as they daily seek to protect and to defend us. Ease their difficulties and encourage them each day. God, we acknowledge that our country's problems are big, but we will remember that our God is bigger. We come before you today to rededicate ourselves to listening to you and following in your Son's name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Please stand for a pledge of
allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. Right, public speakers today, we have one speaker that has signed up, Mr. Tony Cox.
I wish I could get the 30 minutes
to set aside for the people.
I got people ready to give me stuff to talk about, but hey, all that prayer sounds good. All that pledge of allegiance, liberty and justice for all, that sounds good. But we got stupid illegal laws like the noise ordinance. This is as illegal today as it was yesterday, last month, last year. But hey, who cares, right? Till you become the victim. The Alamance County High Impact Land Use and Polluting Industries Ordinance. Illegal. The Barking Dog Ordinance. Illegal. You know, we've seen in Baltimore that we got bad people in our government, and we the people, we come and tell people, hey, these people are doing these things to us, but don't nobody want to hear it. You can pray about it all you want to, but you got to do something. God knows the intent. God knows the intent. God knows the evil wickedness that has been exposed over the last several years of those people that do the wicked things against us in the name of God, good government, that's failing. God's failing. God's failing us. God has failed me. But I still have faith in God. Good God. Not a God that I pray to, which I don't pray. God has already got it worked out for me. I just follow the lead. Go wherever it says go. But hey, and I'll continue to stand here meeting after meeting after meeting and expose it. because it ain't right. You know, they say there's a conflict of interest in Baltimore with the prosecutor. Her husband is a council person. They said he makes the law. Well, if it's a conflict of interest that her husband comes up with laws and she prosecutes laws, how is it not a conflict when county commissioners come up with a law, they have their own enforcer of the law, and then they bring people in here, that enforcer of the law determines whether they're guilty or innocent, and then they bring them in here to this commissioners who come up with this law, shove this law down to people's throats, and then with the good old boys, hey, you're good, go on, keep doing what you want to do. But with others who might stand up and say you're wrong, we'll show you. You know, the funny thing is, in 2007, when all that mess was at the end, Commissioner Larry Sharp stood up and said, told him, said,
"Wait, thank you, Mr. Cox.
We got what we wanted, didn't we?"
All right, any responses from commissioners? All right, moving on. Next, we have the approval of the agenda. Members, there's one change in the agenda for today. It's, if you look at number eight, item number two, is a proclamation for National Police Week 2015 has been added to the agenda. So I'll ask for a motion at this time, approval of the agenda for today as amended. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Motion second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Thank you. All right, consent agenda. Any members have any items they'd like to have pulled from the consent agenda?
I move we approve the consent agenda.
I do have a motion. Second. Motion and second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Thank you. Item number seven, moving right along, public hearing on economic development incentives. Mr. Williams.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman and Commissioners. I'm Mac Williams. I'm President of the Chamber of Commerce for Alamance County. It's my pleasure to be here this morning to introduce members of a company that is considering a location in Alamance County. As you have been reading in recent weeks, we have an international company, or a company that's going international by virtue of them moving to the U.S., we have representatives of a company here who want to bring a piece of that business to Alamance County, hopefully. I have with me this morning representatives from the company MGP Retail Consulting, LLC, who represents the larger company that is making the move into the U.S., and I'm going to let this gentleman come up and tell you about the company and about the project. And answer any questions you or the public might have. And so at this time, it's my pleasure to introduce to you Robert Lester. He is the development manager for MGP Retail Consulting, LLC, and he has with him Peyton Reed, who's the director of real estate for MGP Retail. So with that, without further ado, Robert, I'm going to ask you to come up and introduce MGP Retail and Lidl.
Thank you, Mac.
Yes, sir.
Well, sir.
Hey, good morning.
Good morning.
So I want to thank you, Mac. I also want to thank Chairman Engel and the Alamance County Commissioners for the opportunity to speak with you today. As Mac said, my name is Robert Lester. I'm a development manager with MGP Retail Consulting. I'm joined by Peyton Reeds, our local director of real estate. As you may know and have probably read, MGP Retail Consulting is a wholly owned subsidiary of Lidl Stiftung & Company. Lidl currently operates close to 10,000 stores in 26 countries throughout Europe. Lidl is Europe's largest grocer and one of the largest retailers in the world. Our company and our consultants have been working closely with Mr. Williams for the past few months through the site selection process. He has been very helpful as we seek a location for a regional headquarters and distribution center. We've also worked closely with the city managers for the city of Graham and Mebane, Frankie Manis, and David Cheek, as well as county manager Craig Honeycutt. They've all been very helpful through the process. Throughout our site selection process, we have been considering locations in neighboring states and municipalities. The site here in Alamance County offers several advantages to the company's operations, including convenient access to the state's infrastructure network, a strong workforce in close proximity to major population centers. Alamance also offers reasonable land values and competitive tax rates. We also appreciate the county's efforts to win the company's business by working together with Mebane and Graham and the state of North Carolina to assemble an attractive incentive package. As you know, the company has identified an 86.5-acre site within the North Carolina Commerce Park as the front runner for our site selection process. We're considering constructing an 850,000-square-foot distribution center, which will include an office for a regional headquarters. We expect the project will create a total of 200 new jobs, and the total investment is estimated to be $125 million. On behalf of MGP Retail Consulting, I'd like to respectfully request that the Alamance County Commissioners approve the proposed incentive package. It will provide funding for essential elements of this project while adding significant value to North Carolina Commerce Park. Thank you again for having us here today, and we look forward to taking any questions that you have.
Thank you, Mr. Lester. Question?
I was looking at the job description, and you had 80,000 projected. The 120 hourly, will they be permanent jobs or?
Yeah, they will be permanent jobs. Many of them will be full-time jobs with full benefits. But we are fairly early in our business planning, and so we're not to the point yet that we know the exact number that will be full-time. So we committed, we wanted to be conservative in our commitment, so we committed to 80 full-time jobs and 120 hourly positions.
And I was looking at our tax base here for Alamance County. If you guys choose us, mm-hmm. then you would be our third largest tax contributor in the county because you'd be right behind our LabCorp and Duke Energy.
Well, excellent.
So.
Further questions?
Move approval.
Thank you, Judge. We're going to need to have a public hearing on the first.
Whatever we need.
Go for it.
And, I noticed the average salary for the full-time employees in the 80s. What type of jobs are we talking about here?
Well, the 80 jobs, as you mentioned, will be in the office component, which will that office will act as a regional headquarters, which will oversee the larger geographical region that this distribution center serves. Mm-hmm. So you'll have senior executives all the way through to, down to the associate level positions.
In other words, there'll be several administrative jobs.
There will be administrative jobs. There'll be mid-level management, and there'll be more senior as well.
Is there an estimate of how many folks you'll be bringing in from other areas, and how many of the jobs will be local? Just a rough estimate. I know it's early in the game.
Yeah, that's hard to say until we actually start the hiring process. Yeah. We find that hiring people from the local area seems to be much more sustainable for us, so that would be our goal.
Sounds good.
Well, I think with this will be your first presence in the United States, yeah. from what I've read on your internet sites, and it is a privately owned company.
That's correct.
Okay, and I think it's exciting that we're going to get an opportunity to have this part of it here, but are you looking to place some stores in our area?
We sure are. We are okay. looking throughout the area. It's actually Peyton's main area, and we will have stores locally.
Great concept. I'm always shocked.
Yeah, we're excited to be here.
Well,
we appreciate that.
We thank you, Mr. Lester. And,
sure, thank you.
And thank you, sir. And this is a public hearing. You may have a seat, sir.
Okay.
Thank you. This is a public hearing, and what I'd like to do is at this time is I'll start on this side. Is there anyone on this side that would like to speak for 3 minutes to this economic development consensus agreement? And so please come up and state your name once you come up to the podium. Anyone on this side? Yes, sir. Please come up.
Excuse me. My name is Ken Bourne, born commercial out of Mebane, North Carolina, formerly Cushman & Wakefield out of Northern Virginia. I want to welcome these folks and appreciate the opportunity to bring for Mac to bring you guys in. And I want you to know that this will be a wonderful opportunity for us as well as for you, in which case we will treat you like gold. My guess is. Okay. So, and you'll have all the cooperation from here and from Mebbin and from Graham and otherwise. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Bourne.
Yes, sir.
All right, any others on this side? All right, we'll move over to this side. Anyone on this side like to speak? All right.
I got to do it.
Again, we got jobs. Hey, we come on. Hurry up. People need jobs here. We need more people that have larger incomes that can have a voice for this county. We need more voices for this county. So there are some good people here. And they'll get you built as quick as possible. So good place. Come on.
Thank you, Mr. Cox. Any further on this side? Any further comments from commissioners?
I've got a technical question, I guess, about the road construction. I know we're going to provide, that's the big part of what we're providing to them.
Right, that's the initial direct, yes.
Now, once this road is put in, it will also access other parts of the park there when it's done. On the maintenance side of that, I'm not sure how all that works after all said and done.
It'll be a DIT road.
It ended up being built to DOT standards. And
again, with respect to the road, that's been a wonderful project to work on between Golden Leaf, between the state, between Graham and Mebbin and us and working with the company. It really is a lot of people that have come together to fund this road, and really that was a big issue for them, and we appreciate Light of working with us. So we're excited about the road and again the benefits that we'll have for the entire park.
Well, I'm going to make one other comment and I'm going to shut up, but we went to Cambro's open house last Thursday. Mac was there, and to hear the company president from California talk about his building experience in Alamance County, Mebbin, North Carolina was very impressive. He said he's had plants start in Los Angeles area that it took them years to get it going. They were here and done in a matter of, 9 months, mm-hmm. I think. So we welcome you and hope you find that experience here also.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Right. I would welcome you as well. And I did look at the amount of our investment and the timing of our payments to the company. And the way all that works, this is kind of a no-brainer from a financial aspect.
Right. Well, I think Mr. Cox said it best, jobs. And
jobs.
Jobs are coming in, and it's going to be certainly an economic boom for this area. And welcome also. And with that being said, no further comments from commissioners. Public hearing is closed. We do have a motion from
That motion.
The judge. Second by Commissioner Boswell. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, no. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you very much.
Good luck to you. Appreciate it. All right, moving on to, we have a proclamation, Children's Mental Health Awareness Week.
Linda Jones is here for that.
Linda Jones is here, and I'm going to come down with you, Linda. And if you go ahead and like to speak, first is fine.
Good morning. Thank you all so much for taking just a moment to recognize Children's Mental Health Awareness Week and Children's Mental Health Awareness Day, which will be on Thursday. We appreciate this opportunity to bring this awareness to our community.
All right, Linda. Proclamation, National Children's Mental Health Awareness Week, May 3rd through the 9th, 2015. Whereas mental health is essential to overall health, and whereas addressing the complex mental health needs of children, youth, and families today is fundamental to the future of Alamance County, and whereas the need for comprehensive, coordinated mental health services for children, youth, and families places upon our community a critical responsibility, and whereas it is appropriate that a week should be set apart each year for the direction of our thoughts toward our children's mental health and well-being, And whereas Alamance County, through its unique approach to serving children and adolescents, is effectively caring for the mental health needs of children, youth, and families in our community. And whereas National Children's Mental Health Awareness Week provides an important opportunity for our community to show how children and youth with mental health needs, as well as their families, thrive when they have the right support and services available, and that positive mental health is essential to a child's healthy development from birth. And now, therefore, we, the Alamance County Board of Commissioners, do hereby proclaim May 3rd through the 9th, 2015, to be National Children's Mental Health Awareness Week in Alamance County, and we urge our citizens and all agencies and organizations interested in meeting every child's mental health needs to unite on that day in the observance of such exercises as will acquaint the people of Alamance County with the fundamental necessity of a year-round program for children and youth with mental health needs and their families. Signed this 4th day of May, 2015, Dan Engel and Tori Frick. Thank you, ma'am. Appreciate it. And I'm going to stay down here. We have one more proclamation. Sheriff, come on up, Sheriff. This is a proclamation for National Police Week, the week of May the 10th through the 16th. And Sheriff, you'd like to say a few words about where you're going and what you're doing, and then I'll read this proclamation. I know that's dangerous giving you the floor, but I'll give you the floor.
Take the chance.
Our Honor Guard and some of our members of our agency will be traveling to Washington, D.C. We've been invited to participate in National Law Enforcement Week there, and one of our own who was killed in 1937, Mr. George Jefferson Massey, will have his name on the wall and dedicated during the week. So we're very proud to be able to go, and thank you, Commissioners, for allowing us.
And this I know this is for Alamance County, the officers we lost in the line of duty here with the Sheriff's Office, but it also it pertains to all of our fallen police officers in this county, and I think you would be the first to say that, Sheriff, and
yes,
agree
sir.
With that. Proclamation for National Police Week 2015. To recognize National Police Week 2015 and to honor the service and sacrifice of those law enforcement officers killed in the line of duty while protecting our communities and safeguarding our democracy. Whereas there are approximately 900,000 law enforcement officers serving in communities across the United States, including the dedicated members of the Alamance County Sheriff's Office. Whereas nearly 60,000 assaults against law enforcement officers are reported each year, resulting in approximately 16,000 injuries. Whereas since the first recorded death in 1791, more than 20,000 law enforcement officers in the United States have made the ultimate sacrifice and been killed in the line of duty, including four members of the Alamance County Sheriff's Office. Whereas the names of these dedicated public servants are engraved on the walls of the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial in Washington, D.C. Whereas 273 new names of fallen heroes are being added to the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial this spring, including 117 officers killed in 2014 and 156 killed in previous years. Whereas the service and sacrifice of all officers killed in the line of duty will be honored during the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial Fund's 27th Annual Candlelight Vigil on the evening of May 13th, 2015. Whereas the Candlelight Vigil is part of the National Police Week, which takes place this year on May 10th through the 16th. Whereas May 15th is designated as Peace Officers Memorial Day in honor of all fallen officers and their families, and U.S. flags should be flown at half-staff. Therefore, be it resolved that the Alamance County Board of Commissioners formally designates May the 10th through the 16th of 2015 as Police Week in Alamance County, and publicly salutes the service of law enforcement officers in our community and in communities across the nation. Signed this 4th day of May, 2015, Dan Engel, Tory Frick.
Thank you very much.
Thank you,
Commissioner.
Mr. Chair, do you want to do the SOAR Award while you're there?
I can do, sir. Right. I was going to ask the commissioners. I apologize. Any comments on either one of these?
Well, first, I want to thank Linda for coming today, and I think the helping our young children is going to help our sheriff later on, because the more we have helping our kids to have a better life will help them on the back end, and those dollars invested in childhood things are well worth the money spent.
Thank you. Any further comments? All right, we have, I was going to do this during commissioner's comments, but I'm down here, and that's okay. That's a good good idea from the manager. Thank you for that. We have a quarterly SOAR award that we give out for the outstanding for employee excellence. And I'd like to present, for this third quarter, I'd like to present the award. This time, it goes to Jesse Ayers. Jesse, if you come on up, sir. Jesse is with the Alamance County Maintenance Department. And he was nominated for Alamance County SOAR Award for Employee Excellence, as I stated, during the third quarter for this year. Here's an excerpt from the nomination that was submitted. During the night on Wednesday, February 4th, the boiler at DSS had to be shut down. It was very cold outside the next morning, but when I arrived at work at 6:30 a.m., Jesse had the building toasty warm in almost all areas. He was very concerned about all areas being comfortable for both the employees of DSS and the clients who would be coming into DSS and the health department that day. I understand that Jesse was at work at 5 a.m. that morning to make sure that he had favorable working conditions. When I arrived, he had a smile on his face and a very positive attitude. This was repeated on Friday, February 6th, with the same cheerfulness and positive attitude. I've observed this young man at other times going about his maintenance work at DSS and the health department with the same smile and kind words. He appears to be a very pleasant young man with a distinction to this county and the buildings where he works. And your award, sir, and we thank you for the job you're doing, outstanding job. Thank you, sir. Next, we have the State of the County Health Department report for 2014. Ms. Saunders, our health director.
Good morning.
Everybody's well, right?
That's right. I get the pleasure of presenting the State of the County Health report for 2014 to you all. And for those of you who are not as familiar, the State of the County Health report is the health documentation that we do in the years between the community health assessment, which is that really large document that sets the priorities for health concerns in our county at least every 4 years, and our cycle is 3 years to match with our hospital, who also has accreditation requirements. And you're seeing this report, usually you all would see this report in sort of January, but the North Carolina Division of Public Health changed deadline dates from December of that year that it's due, which would be December 2014 for us in the old way. The state changed that to March of the following year, so March 2015. So you're sort of seeing this at a different time than you usually would. And I'm going to go very quickly through it because I'm sure that you'll want to read each and every piece of it in your leisure time. The front page are just the demographics, which you all are probably very familiar with. So I'm going to jump into the priority areas. And like I said, based on the community health assessment, which we did the last time in 2011, four priority areas were identified in that community assessment, which were access to care, obesity, substance abuse, and mental health. And so this report shows the progress from 2013 to 2014 in those four top priority areas. And so under access to health care, the progress made, the two biggest things that we talk about in the SOCH are the transportation issue that the City of Burlington began to tackle, and the activity around Affordable Care Act. And so this past year was our second cycle with the Affordable Care Act. And in the first cycle, you'll see there's a little bit of information in there that at that time we identified about 25,000 individuals in Alamance County that were uninsured. And of those, about 10,000 were believed to be eligible for either Medicaid or the federal marketplace. And at the end of that first cycle of the Affordable Care Act, about 5,000 of those 10,000 received either Medicaid or marketplace, or were enrolled in the marketplace during the first enrollment period. So that's roughly about 50% of what we were targeting for the first for the first enrollment period. And as of January 16th of this year, which was not quite midway through the second enrollment period, about 6,000 individuals had already enrolled or re-enrolled into Medicaid or the federal marketplace. And we work, the health department works in conjunction with the United Way, DSS, the hospital, Healthy Alamance, to help coordinate some enrollment activities and events in the actual county for those enrollment periods for Affordable Care Act. The next priority area is the substance abuse area. The progress made, we had two medicine drop boxes installed in our county this past year, one at the Mebane Police Department and the second at the Burlington Police Department. And this was after several years of work and through the partnership of Cone Health and Alamance Regional Medical Center's Safe Kids Alamance County, which is a coalition, a local coalition, and Alamance Citizens for a Drug-Free Community and Healthy Alamance. And since their installation, the Mebane site alone has collected almost 800 pounds of expired or unused medicine. And this is one of the activities that we and all those other folks do to get prescription medications out of homes and out of the hands of small children or folks who are going to misuse them. And also, the health department worked with the community transformation grant staff. And if you'll remember, the community transformation grant was a large regional grant that the health department participated in, and that actually sunsetted in December of 2014. But a lot of those activities are included in the SOCH because of the priority areas were included in there. So that community transformation grant staff and the health department staff worked to look at smoking policies in multi-unit housing complexes, so apartment complexes, and actually had a couple of those housing complexes change their smoking policies to no smoking. And the benefits to that are to families, children, young children, pregnant women, and so on. And also our local minor league baseball team, the Burlington Royals, went 100% tobacco free at their park in that same time. The next priority area is mental health, and timely that you all are also celebrating mental health awareness. We have several things happening around mental health, a lot happening around early childhood mental health and families, but I also wanted to make note that Cardinal Innovations, who's the mental health provider in Alamance County, hosted about 10 mental health first aid trainings. And the mental health first aid is a full-day course that helps folks and community members identify someone who may be experiencing or needing help. So it's not actually a licensed clinical social worker. It's me, it's you, being able to say to somebody, I think you need help, and being able to show them how to get help. So over 50 community members received the training in 2014. And then you'll notice that there are the two last parts of this report for the mental health piece highlight our two large SAMHSA grants, the one that the health department has for Project Launch and the one that DSS has for the Alliance for Children and Families. And under the Project Launch piece, which is the prevention arm of that early childhood mental health that the health department initiates, there were 40 service providers trained in Triple P in 2014. We also continued those two early childhood mental health provider teams in the private practices, Burlington Peds and Kernodle, and the health department actually adopted a team as well. And in that time, our team, which is a licensed clinical social worker and a family health navigator, they were able to reach over 200 families in 2014, and they only began in August. So a testament to the dedication to early childhood mental health. And then for the Alamance Alliance for Children and Families, which is the intervention arm and the SAMHSA grant that DSS has, in 2014, they provided 11 trainings on early brain development and early childhood trauma to more than 200 people. And they also have started to have more of their outcome data come out that showed that 18 months of service improved initiative and self-control, and they also had 24-month data that caregivers indicated less overall distress and less difficult interactions with children. And that goes to the front-end prevention piece to see the big outcomes later on in life. And the last priority area is obesity. And You'll see a lot of things in here with that community transformation grant. Again, that sunsetted in December of 2014, but that was a large regional grant that we had a huge piece in. There's talk in there about the comprehensive land use plans that Burlington and Graham have begun, also the trail plans that you all have heard about through Parks and Rec. And we also have a lot of information in there about the local farmers markets, which the CTG grant, the community transformation grant, used a lot of their funding to enhance local farmers markets, to have people come back into the farmers and support local economy and the local farmers. And those efforts were made in Mebane, Burlington, Hall River, North Park, Elon, and Saxapaw. We also have information in there about the physical activity and recreation challenge, which we call the Park Passport, which the health department collaborated with the United Way of Alamance County and really enhanced that program to have a more interactive and social media platform. We were just using small tangible passport books, and this past year we were doing more Facebook, website, and Foursquare to help people get connected with each other. And so if your friend was out at the park and said, I'm on Foursquare and I'm at the park, and then you'll go out to the park. And so we were getting people out into the parks and moving more. And we also had a small grant through our child care development center in Mebane, got a small Mebane on the Move grant, and we assisted them with technical assistance in creating a preschool garden that was maintained by their 3 and 4 year olds and actually had yield. It was amazing. So the little people were growing their own tomatoes and squash and broccoli at one point. And so very interesting. And in that, even that small intervention, we saw an increase in vegetables being served at the child care facility, fresh vegetables. So we're hoping to be able to expand on that. And also in the county health report, there are other sections, including the emerging diseases. And this year for us, communicable disease was one of those things that we, in our daily operation of doing preventive public health and chronic disease, which is typically what causes the most morbidity and mortality in our county, communicable disease comes up ever so often to remind us, don't forget where you came from, and that infectious disease is where sort of public health came out of. And so this year we had four new vocabulary words, which were chikungunya, MERS, EVD68, and Ebola, that we added to our repertoire, and spent more than 2,000 hours of preparedness on those communicable disease and planning. The next section is the morbidity and mortality, and no big surprises here. This is the section that sort of updates everybody. Have the leading causes of death and sickness changed? And they've not for us overall. Cancer, heart disease, and chronic lower respiratory diseases are the top three causes of death in Alamance County. You'll see that our communicable diseases, particularly gonorrhea and syphilis, gonorrhea rates are decreasing. Syphilis rates are staying about the same. Infant mortality increased slightly, but that's based on a small sample size. So when you see that number year to year, that fluctuates quite a lot because of the small sample size. We actually look at 5-year trend data more for that, and that over the last 15 years, we've seen a 24% decrease in infant mortality. Same thing with the teen pregnancy. We're seeing decreased teen pregnancy rates, and over the last 15 years we've actually seen a 41% decrease in teen pregnancy rates in our county, which is incredible. And then we also like to highlight any new initiatives that are happening through the health department or in the county, and here you'll see three highlighted, including the Alamance Baby Closet, which is designed after the Guilford County model, and helps clients get things that they need for their baby, but also does an intervention and prevention and education piece with it. The Safe Kids Alamance, the health department actually became the lead agency for that, and there's a lot of information about what that coalition is now doing and has been very successful in getting grants for bike helmets, car seats, and cribs for kids. And we also have initiated a literacy-rich waiting room. This goes along with the early childhood mental health initiatives that we're doing through the health department and through DSS, and reach out, and we're using the reach out and read model to engage families, parents, caregivers, and their children in reading, because we know that does so much for the brain structure in early childhood development. And the last piece is just sort of is the Alamance County Health Department's annual numbers. So this is just from 2013 to 2014, what we did, and you all can peruse that as you like. Any questions?
I'd like to make a comment. I think it's commendable the collaboration that you use in putting together this report and in taking all these interventions. I know a lot of communities do not work together with their health departments, or the health departments don't work so well with the community agencies and all, and this health department really does. So yeah. I had a question about the access to health care and the Affordable Care Act and the Medicaid. So I think you said that there were about 25,000 uninsured people in Alamance County, and that there were 10,000 that could be insured by enrolling in the Affordable Care Act or being enrolled in Medicaid. Mm-hmm. How many more would have been could have been enrolled in Medicaid had the state passed the Medicaid expansion?
That's a great question, and I do not know the number off the top of my head. I'll go back and check that, because I know Susan and I played around. Susan Osborne, the DSS director, did discuss that early on in the Affordable Care Act, but I do not recall the number off the top of my head, but I can find that for you.
Okay, thanks. And then on the enrollment in the Affordable Care Act plans, the number that you gave was as of January 15th?
That's correct.
Now that it's closed, do you have a sense of what the total
is? We don't. We've
is?
Not seen the actual final report yet. And we actually work with not only DSS and United Way and local folks, but UNC as well with that. And we've not seen the final report from UNC at this point.
I've got one question. Stacy, on the drop boxes you have for medications,
yes,
and stuff, you have two in the
yes
county. Is that an option that we could look to expand that?
I'm so
to
glad
make
you
it
said something
more,
about that.
Open for people,
yes,
to get rid of medications. I know having elderly parents have died, and you
right
got medication, and you know, what do? Well, you take it to the drugstore or whatever,
right,
and let them dispose of it. But
so there are plans. We do have the two permanent boxes in Mebane and Burlington, but we also have events during the year that typically will happen at Holly Hill Mall that Safe Kids Alamance County actually coordinates. But we're also looking as a health department. There is a statewide sort of initiative called Project Lazarus that came out of Wilkes County that looks at decreasing prescription overdose or misuse. And there is potential for us to have money coming from the state, small pots of money, to help our community place another medicine drop box. So we're already talking to folks in our community about where would we need another one. We have one in the east, we have one sort of centrally located, should we look at the west?
And you have people in the rural counties. Where,
absolutely,
where do they go,
and where do
to
they go
do those type, get rid of those products, because some of the elderly folks don't drive, but they have a lot of medication,
yes,
that they've acquired over the years that need to be gotten rid of.
Yes. So we are talking to the Alamance Citizens for a Drug-Free Community Coalition, which is Karen Webb's group, mm-hmm, and also the folks at Alamance Regional Medical Center about where,
okay,
strategically, where should we put the next one.
Well, I look forward
there
to
are
that.
There are some rules associated with that, are there not?
There are some DEA rules about that
right,
that we have to...
Well, of course.
And we don't want people to flush them down the toilet. That's not
that's right.
That's
supplier.
Right. That's why the more right options they have to dispose of.
And these older people are likely to have children that could be
that's
entering
right
the house
that's
and
true
discovering those things,
yeah,
as well and taking them.
Correct.
Or selling them at school.
Or selling them, yeah.
Stacy, you mentioned that infant mortality was down.
Mm-hmm. Slightly
up this year. Mm-hmm. SIDS, you don't hear that much about SIDS anymore. Are we having any...
So we have one of the things that I've not looked at the actual breakdown of what caused each death, because we have so few. Each year to year, it fluctuating just by one. If we had two deaths the previous year and we fluctuate by one, it increases our rate astronomically just because that small sample size. And typically the state doesn't like for us to pull all of that data to sort of see what that infant died from, because when you're getting to those small numbers, you're also getting very close to the line of HIPAA and confidentiality.
Just because of the small numbers.
Because of the small numbers.
Yeah.
I will say, in a general sense, when we look at either our 5-year trends or our 15-year trends, the most prominent reason for death for infants is prematurity, low birth weight, something related to those two things, or a genetic anomaly that happens. Okay. That they typically happen very early on.
Any further questions?
Well, I just want to say back to what Bob said. Yeah. Thanks for collaborating. Yes. And do what
absolutely.
You
we are a very fortunate county.
Yeah. Well, absolutely. Thank you. We appreciate it.
Thank you all.
Thank you. All right, next on the agenda, we have the approval of a planned transportation project, Governor Scott Farm Road.
Okay. Thank you, Chairman. As part of General Statute Chapter 135, Article 1, in working with the DOT, any project that they do over $150,000 that is a combination with a local government, this project is the extension for Lytle. With Mebane and Graham as well. Any project basically says that we're aware of it and we have to pass a resolution saying that the project's over $150,000, you're participating, you're aware we're participating, we're aware you're participating, just making sure that everybody has bought into the project as we move forward. So if this is so approved, we will do a resolution up and send that back based upon this information.
All right. Any questions? You hear a motion of approval of resolution of participation in this project.
Make a motion to approve.
Motion to have a second.
Second.
All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Thank you. And now we're ready for your reports.
First thing that you do have in your agenda is an interlocal agreement between the Tourism Development Authority and Alamance County. As the board is aware of, that it is the TDA is a component of Alamance County government. Their funding comes from a direct pass-through through the occupancy tax, so we provide them 2/3 of that revenue. They have always been a part of the chamber, under the chamber's umbrella, and recently they've kind of had a separation as far as mission. Robert is here if you have any questions, but we've never really had a formal agreement with the TDA that set out the responsibilities of the TDA, set out the responsibilities of the TDA board, or the Alamance County Board of Commissioners. So this really kind of formalizes what they have been doing in the past, but it gives the county a little bit more oversight that the chamber used to be doing, but now Robert will be coming and making presentations to the board on a quarterly basis about activities going on within the TDA.
Did there used to be an agreement between the TDA and the chamber, mm-hmm. similar
yes.
to this?
Yes.
We just dealt straight with the chamber.
We dealt straight with the chamber. We've never formally dealt directly with the TDA. It was always through the chamber, and the TDA is in the process of getting its own separate 501c3. So this would set out the responsibilities of both the TDA and the county.
So today you just this is informational purposes.
Well, need for you to make sure that you're okay with the agreement as written, and
does everybody have a copy?
I'm sorry.
I have
pretty
one.
Big.
Yeah,
okay.
Well, I'll
get back.
Yeah, that's it.
I thought it looked familiar when I saw
it. We had several very similar to that.
That's so just to be clear.
We have worked with the TDA board. The TDA board has approved this, but we have worked with Clyde to come up with this final document.
So moved.
And this funding, we do have a motion. This funding comes from the occupancy
yes,
tax
sir.
Is where it comes from.
And just to be clear, Robert, you and your staff are your own employees. I mean, you have your own
correct.
Corporation.
Correct.
But did that used to be the case, or were you employees of the chamber before, technically?
We were officially considered employees of the chamber, although the original structure said that we were also TDA employees.
Right.
So it clears up some.
Where's your location now? Maybe the letter.
We're in the historic train depot.
Okay, so you're not in the chamber building anymore.
No, sir.
So.
Well, I second the motion.
All right, have a motion and a second that we enter to an interlocal agreement with the Alamance County Tourism Development Authority. Those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. All right, thank you.
Have just a couple of mention. One is the joint school facilities meeting is this Wednesday at 9:30 at the Family Justice Center. You should have received a copy of the agenda on that. And also next Monday night, starting at 5:30, is six. Is our joint meeting with the City of Burlington.
What was the first one you just told me?
Family Justice Center on Wednesday.
That's the joint facility.
And for I think you'll be out of town there.
Yeah, I'll be in Raleigh at the North Carolina Association of County Commissioners that day, so right. I'll miss it.
Yeah, that's right. Our joint meeting.
Yeah.
Okay.
But those are the two important meetings coming up, and that's all I have at this point.
All right. Thank you, sir. All right, moving on to commissioners' comments. Any comments from commissioners?
The only thing, just to remind the commissioners, and I know the sheriff probably has got their invite to the Pentecostal church this week for the day of prayer. It is Thursday. And they, it's a nice event they do for local
12:30
representatives, yeah.
Any others? I have some.
No, I don't have any.
We do have an opening on the Alamance Community College Board of Trustees, and what I thought with consensus of agreement from the board, what we will do is advertise and allow folks to apply with the county here through the 27th at noon. That means Wednesday 27th. Tori, that'll give you time to get the applications to us in the agenda. That sound good? And then we'll take it under consideration at our June 1st meeting.
I appreciate you doing that because I've had two now to come approach me.
I would like
to serve.
I had several calls, so we can get them together and we'll discuss them and make a decision. And the community college meets again June the 8th, so we'll make that decision on the 1st and pass it on to them unless I hear otherwise.
On consensus, I agree.
By consensus, that's a good thing. Any further from anyone? With no further, meeting's adjourned. I think that worked pretty good.
Thank you for watching the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building, located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Typically, the first meeting of the month is held at 9 a.m., and the second meeting is held at 7 p.m. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioner's website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel, beginning at 10 p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions regarding this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of the commissioners' meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information on the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.